The women folk of Mahila Uttan Mandal, run by the divine inspiration of Pujya Sant Sri Asharamji Bapu, have made an exemplary endeavor by extending an extraordinary service in connection with the 83rd incarnation day of Sant Sri Asharamji Bapu. Yes, this time women of Mahila Uttan Mandal have organized community food amongst specially abled beings. Since early in the morning, the women folk started preparations for cooking palatable delicacies for the sightless inmates of Andhijan Mandal, situated at Vastrapur in Ahmedabad. Though the sightless men of the institution were unable to see it all happening, yet the aroma of delicious food items was indicative enough that this day carries special bearing for them all. They all were benefited by the mellifluous chant of Lord Hari's pious name.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
And then arrived the time for mouth-watering festivity. Following the tenets of the ashram, there was chant of mantras before taking meals, and then, with utmost regard, the food prasadam was distributed amongst them. This sight was spectacular indeed.
Om Harir Data, Harir Bhukta, Harir Annam Prajapati, Harir Sarvo Sharirasto, Bhukte Bhojayate Hari.
These women not only prepared food with utmost affection, but also served it with the same warmth and hospitality. The expressions of these debilitated inmates were indicative enough to illustrate as if they have tasted homely food after numerous years, because today the taste of food was imbued with sisterly and motherly affection.
This is a unique opportunity for us that we've arrived amidst the specially abled beings and arranged for the community food, made them recite Harinam Sankirtana and distributed noble literature amongst them. They were immensely elated at this, and we too experienced great ecstasy.
Every responsible person associated with this organization enormously thanked the volunteers of revered Bapuji.
Today, I am greatly pleased that the sisters of the Mahila Uttan Mandal came to our organization and created a truly spiritual ambience explicitly to be enjoyed by the participants. I'm really grateful to all the sisters who have extended their selfless service to the students of our organization. Since early morning, they've not only delightfully cooked food for everyone, but also cordially served with a smile on their faces. All the participants are extremely thrilled, and I'm also glad to see them overjoyed. The task of uniting our students with the mainstream of the society by this organization is highly commendable. This aspect is truly laudable and exemplary one.
We are truly indebted to you all for the community food that was arranged in our organization by the Mahila Uttan Mandal Motera, duly inspired by Shri Asharamji Bapu. The most overwhelming thing is that all the women of your organization have personally cooperated in carrying out this activity. Right from chopping the vegetables till serving the food, so we reckon it as a notable service. And we thank you from the bottom of our heart.
Then these women distributed worthy literature amongst them, which was cordially On the other hand, the women volunteers of the Mahila Uttan Mandal also extended their services in the women hostel of Andhijan Mandal.
Okay. In connection with the incarnation day of Sant Shri Asharam Ji Bapu, the women folk of Mahila Uthan Mandal that have arrived here have imparted many teeny tiny tips to our students, and these will be really useful to them and render them successful in their lives. We truly felt great by their altruistic service.
Here too they sang paeans of glory in the kirtana of Lord Hari's pious name, followed by pure and nutritious community food as prasadam. The cordial affability and harmony was evident here also as before. The women volunteers of Mahila Uthan Mandal are practically swift enough to determine some or the other service befitting every occasion. This time the occasion was Akshaya Tritiya. So they chose to distribute cold sherbet at every nook and corner to get Akshaya Phala, that is, eternal meritorious effect recorded in their names. In the scorching heat of the day, these women folk provided relief to the people by serving them cool and fresh drink and also assigned immense delight to themselves. Who wouldn't like to savor the unusual sherbet of Palash, and that too prepared with utmost purity and precision? What to talk of a bus stop, a railway station, a road or crossroads? Practically, one and all preferred to halt and enjoy the sweet aromatic sherbet.
Today we have set up this corner here for the free service of sherbet. People are thronging here in large numbers. The amount of fulfilling thrill visible at their faces after savoring the sherbet during this blazing heat is more than enough to make us feel happy and delighted. Besides the distribution of sherbet, we are also giving the spiritual magazines of our ashram, Rishi Prasad and Lok Kalyan Setu.
I felt immense contentment after drinking the sherbet. The selfless service which is being carried out is imbued with divine sentiment. Apart from imbibing the noble spiritual impressions, it is truly an exceptional endeavor for the humanity and also an exemplary obligation for the general populace.
Just see how delightfully people are guzzling down the drops of sherbet and accepting the noble literature of revered Bapuji with utmost regard.
Let's have furthermore view of the services extended by the women volunteers of Mahila Uthan Mandal.